Thank you for showing interest in our paper about feminist living labs as research infrastructures for HCI. So we know that the IT field remains male-dominated and design teams still tend to be comprised of young, white, educated men. In terms of technology production, such as, for example, video games, this is actually problematic because the absence of diverse perspectives can contribute to fundamental design flaws. In response to this, studies examining the gendered nature of technology and, following this, explicit feminist agendas in HCI design research have gained traction in recent years. How to best conceptualize and act upon the problem of integrating gender awareness into design practice yet remains a matter of debate. Putative solutions embrace co-production approaches such as participatory design or participatory action research, approaches which, of course, require a certain degree of co-production with research participants. We propose living labs as such a participatory methodology for feminist HCI. Living labs with their long-term co-design research infrastructures in real-life environments and their ambition to share diverse perspectives arguably take the aforementioned approaches a step further via the integration of diverse stakeholders from several sectors, who then form a network of excellence. And this provides all involved parties with a more holistic picture of a problem situation, which in turn supports mutual learning. Research in such labs usually takes place in iterative cycles. It is important to note that historically, living lab research has involved technological interventions, but this is not a necessary feature. The infrastructure can be used to design any kind of innovative idea or measure for intervention in a social system, for example, experience sharing, case studies, opportunities for learning, etc. Having said that, a living lab research infrastructure is not per se feminist. The main aim of our paper then is to offer a methodological contribution, reporting how our explicit commitments to feminist HCI influenced our living lab process. We do so by presenting a detailed case study of the collaboration with one stakeholder of our lab, a video game company from Germany. Our case study is based upon 2.5 years of an ongoing 3-year gender and living lab project in Germany. Scientific knowledge transfer and exchange among stakeholders into real-life environments is at the core of the project. The shared goal of all stakeholders is to strengthen the role of female talent in IT organizations. Our lab was informed by feminist participatory action research, which aims at giving marginalized groups a voice. Our approach to the fieldwork then was in the tradition of institutional ethnography, which especially aims to make the viewpoint of the researched women central to the research and focuses on everyday experiences. Our stakeholder pool consisted of 11 gender-mixed HCI and business informatics students from our local university, whom we interviewed about their expectations around future employment, data which was then cross-referenced with insights from other stakeholders. We also organized 5 symposia across Germany for dissemination purposes with approximately 50 to 80 participants. Attendees of these symposia were diverse, for example, company representatives, consultants, students, and trainees from IT-related areas, as well as researchers, including us. Symposia were established as a ground for stakeholder interactions, where workshops were organized. A vital element of the lab are 6 organizations with whom we aim to collaborate closely via extensive fieldwork. As you can see, those organizations come from different sectors and deal with their individual research questions based upon real-life gender-related problem situations. This allows us both collecting different cases for each organization as well as cross-cutting comparisons across several industries. The video game company is then the specific focus of this paper. Here you can see some information about said company. The occupations of our female and male participants ranged from project manager with lead responsibility to artist, quality management, human resources, communication, UX, etc. To our knowledge, our gender mixed participants identify as cisgender, were in their 20s or 30s, and some had a migratory or international background. Throughout the time frame described in this paper, we went through 2 iterative cycles. The first phase took place in 2018 and the second one in 2019. Work with this company involved observations, interviews, 2 focus groups, as well as the organization of workshops at 3 symposia. Our methodological toolbox for Living Lab research consisted in mainly qualitative approaches. Data came from interview transcripts, field notes, notes about informal talks, and documented workshop results. During the evaluation phase of the first cycle, we relied on interviews and observations to collect data in the company. This helped us to gain a richer understanding of the context and give voice to personal sentiments of our participants. Following the first month in the field, after collecting and analyzing this data, we were able to identify critical building blocks as desired by an HR participant at one of the initial meetings, which cover the lifetime of an employee within a company. It became clear that women are confronted with gendered practices at all stages of their career progression, and those areas became then instructive for the continuation of our research process. What followed was a symposium workshop in collaboration with two company representatives, often offering the company and additional stakeholders a creative space for brainstorming and reflection. The topics of the workshops in the main emerged from topics of concern identified through fieldwork. Throughout the first cycle, additional parallel activities in our Living Lab involved interviewing students from our local university with a view to obtaining a picture of initial expectations, and this data was used as well for designing branding policies. After analyzing this initial data, we organized a focus group, and this activity finalized the first cycle. The second cycle started with another symposium workshop. Later that year, a 60-minute presentation was held within the company where we discussed our insights with a broader audience. After this, a second focus group followed. Crucially, we also broadened up the participants. Our contact person encouraged participants with the right mindset, and as a result, two women and three men joined the second focus group. The second cycle was concluded by a third symposium workshop. We identified four themes which shaped our feminist Living Lab work with the video game company: participation process, experiencing common standpoints, understanding context, and giving access to resources and the creative space. In our paper, we then discussed several lessons learned, and we would be happy if we triggered your interest in taking a look at them. The value of the Living Lab lies in its marriage between ideological orientation, understanding of practice, and pragmatic cooperative policymaking. We hope that our case study of a methodological approach will be helpful for other researchers to integrate the broad commitments of feminist HCI into HCI research.